Thank you very much for the invitation to participate in this meeting. It's a pleasure to be here with my friends and colleagues, Ifigenia, David and Dagan. And I will talk about the Portuguese cooperative code. Well, in Portugal, since 1980, cooperative legislation has been concentrated in a code called Cooperative Code. The codification of the cooperative legislation allows the affirmation of the regulatory autonomy of cooperative law, which is present as a coherent body of rules regulating entities with specific characteristics and based on principles, the cooperative principles that gave it system consistency. This diploma groups the legal rules that regulate cooperatives, regardless of which branch each belongs. Among the matters deal with the code are the definition, the establishment, dissolution, the right and duties of cooperative members, the organizational structure, the economic regime. It is not, however, a closed and self-sufficient body of rules. Thus, if there is any insufficiency in the cooperative code, the corporate law shall be directly applied by reference, provided that the cooperative principles are not disrespected. It should be noted that cooperatives are granted separate legal status under Portuguese law by the Constitution of the Portuguese Republic, which dedicates more than 1,000 articles to the cooperatives. We found a set of principles in the Portuguese Constitution, such as the principle of coexistence of three sectors, the public sector, the private sector, and the cooperative and social sector, the principle of freedom of cooperatives initiatives, the principle of protection of the social and cooperative sector, the principle of the obligation of the state to encourage and support the creation of cooperatives, and the principle of compliance with the ICA cooperative principles. The cooperative identity is always present in the Portuguese cooperative legislation. Let's analyze the legal regime of cooperatives set out in the cooperative code. Since it's impossible to make an exhaustive analysis of the regime, I will focus on the aspects that I consider most relevant. Let's start with the legal definition of the cooperative in the second article of the code. The article 2 of the Portuguese code states that cooperatives are an autonomous association of persons freely associated of variable composition and capital, which through cooperation and mutual assistance of its members and in obedience to cooperative principles aims not at profit, but at satisfying economic, social, of cultural needs and aspiration of the said members. It follows from the definition that cooperatives are autonomous legal persons. This means that cooperatives are an autonomous type of legal person, distinct for either associations or companies. On the other hand, the legislator wanted to include a reference to the cooperative principle of autonomy and independence in the concept of cooperatives. Cooperatives are freely established. The legislator wanted to include in the concept of the cooperative a reference to the cooperative principle of voluntary and open membership. Cooperatives have variable capital and composition. The legislator wanted to include in the concept of cooperative a reference to the principle of voluntary and open membership and consequent reimbursement of capital contribution, which confers variability to the share capital and to the corporate composition. The cooperative is characterized by the cooperation and mutual assistance of its members. This is a projection of the mutualistic purpose of the cooperative. Cooperatives should operate by respecting the cooperative principles. The cooperative principles are mandatory in the cooperative Portuguese law. And we have a reference of the cooperative principles in the definition of cooperatives. Cooperatives are not for profit, because the scope of the cooperatives is the satisfaction of the economic, social, or cultural needs and aspiration of the members, the mutualistic scope. And cooperatives do not have only economic aims, but are addressed to the cooperative members as a whole. Well, the following is the issue of the establishment. The incorporation of primary cooperatives must be conducted in writing. The incorporation of a cooperative is decided by a meeting of its founder members. The board of the founders meeting shall write the minutes, which must mention its social object, assets, rights, work or service contribute by the cooperative members. And these rules apply to the secondary degree cooperatives. According to the code, the name adopted by the cooperatives shall always be followed by the expression cooperatives, union of cooperatives, federation or confederation. The use of the word cooperatives, it's exclusively reserved for cooperatives. The cooperative acquires legal personality with the registration of its incorporation based on the article on the Portuguese Cooperative Code. The Incorporation Act is published on a public access internet site. And the cooperatives must also comply with the legal obligation to register the Incorporation Act with the Cooperative António Sérgio para a Economia Social, CASES. It's an important organ that has important supervision functions in the cooperative sector. According to the number of members, the code states that the cooperative is of variable and unlimited, but shall not be less than 3 members in primary cooperatives and 2 members in upper level cooperatives. The cooperative is obligated to accept third parties as members if they comply with the admission requirements of members. The statutes of each cooperative must contain the admission requirements of members, and the candidate must apply for admission to the board of directors of the cooperative. If a candidate meets those conditions, the proposed admission remains subject to the approval by the board of directors. This resolution is mandatory for the acquisition of membership, and the general meeting will act always as an appeal body as to the admission or rejections of new members. Following cooperative membership, cooperators are the reference members of cooperatives. The cooperative is born to satisfy the needs of the corporate members. But the Portuguese cooperative code includes the possibility of the statutes admitting investor members. These investor members shall not participate in cooperative transactions, limiting themselves to contribute financially to the cooperative. But the Portuguese legislator defined a set of rules to the investor members in the name of the obedience to the principle of democratic member control and the principle of autonomy and independence. So the admission of investor members is subject to statutory provision and must be approved by the general meeting after a proposal by the board of directors. Plural vote may be assigned to investor members in condition and criteria to be laid down by the statutes and always in obedience to the cooperative principle of democratic member control and autonomy and independence. All the members of cooperatives are granted the right to leave or resign. It's a fundamental right of the cooperators. The legislator provides for the possibility of establishing rules and conditions for the exercise of the right of resignation in the statutes. The statutes may limit, but never abolish the right of resignation. Well, about voting rights, this is an important issue of the Portuguese legal regime. The rule is each cooperator has one vote, regardless of its participation in the share capital. But in the cooperatives of first degree, the plural vote is admitted, but always with an exceptional character. It's the admission of the plural vote will always be subject to mandatory rules in respect to the cooperative principles. The plural vote is not allowed in all the branches, in all the cooperatives. It's not allowed in worker cooperatives, handicraft, fishery, consumer, and social solidarity cooperatives. In the other cooperatives, the plural vote can only be accepted in cooperatives with more than 20 cooperators. The plural voting of cooperators can only be allocated based on the cooperator activity in the cooperative and not on the basis of participation in the share capital. Cooperatives of up to 20 cooperators shall not be assigned more than 3 votes per cooperator or investor members, and cooperatives with more than 50 cooperators shall not be assigned more than 5 votes each. Well, about internal structure, the cooperative bodies are 3, the general meeting, the board of directors, and the supervisory board. The general meeting is considered by law as the supreme body of the cooperative, composed by all the members. And why the legislator called the general meeting the supreme body of the cooperative? Because its decisions are binding for all other bodies. Its resolutions are compulsory for all bodies of the cooperative and to all its members. All cooperators and investor members may participate in the general meeting. About the management and supervision of the cooperative, we have 3 models, 3 options. First model, a board of directors and a supervisory board. Second model, a board of directors with an audit committee and a statutory auditor. Third model, an executive board of directors, a general and supervisory board, and a statutory auditor. Each cooperative must choose the model of management and supervision to adopt, and its choice has to be modeled on the cooperative statutes. In cooperatives that have up to 20 members, the possibility of a sole director is admitted and a sole supervisor. The members of the governance bodies are always elected among the cooperators. About cooperative financial structure. In the Portuguese law, it's not possible to form a cooperative without share capital. The initial share capital must necessarily be determined in the cooperative statutes, the cooperator is only considered a member after contributing to the share capital, but the principal obligation of the cooperator is not to this economic contribution, but participating in the economic activity of the cooperative. Share capital is divided in shares, which we call títulos de capital, whose value cannot be below €5 each. Each cooperator shall have a minimum contribution of 3 shares. There are some limitations applicable to investor members. The statutes may provide for the admission of investor members whose total sum of the entries may not exceed 30% of the entries made in the cooperative. This is very important, is the way to respect the cooperative principles of democratic member control and autonomy and independence. Some cooperatives have mandatory contributions in capital and labor. It's the case of worker cooperatives, services cooperatives, and craft cooperatives. About surplus allocation, the law allows that surplus may return to the cooperators and define a criteria of distribution. The cooperative surplus may return to cooperators as patronage refunds in proportion to the business performed by each of them with or for the cooperative during that financial year. The economic surplus arising for transaction with non-members may not be shared, being necessarily allocated to indivisible reserves. And why? Because these results are profits. A percentage of the cooperative surplus of the financial year in transaction with the cooperators will be allocated to the legal reserve and to the reserve for cooperative education and training. These two reserves, the legal reserve and the reserve for education and training, are mandatory reserves and are very important financial instruments of the cooperatives. The legislator prevents the distribution of surplus when and to the extent that is necessary to cover accumulated losses or to reconstitute the legal reserve. The law provides the possibility for members to obtain a net compensation on the capital under writing as a condition of membership. When interest is paid, its total amount should not exceed 30% of the annual net results. This compensation will be dependent on the fulfillment of two conditions, its statutory provision and the existence of positive results. Finally, about dissolution and conversion. In Portugal, in case of dissolution, residual net assets should be allocated in accordance with the principle of disinterest distribution. These residual net are distributed to the community or other associate cooperatives. In the case of winding up of the cooperative, the cooperator shall only be entitled to recover his contribution to the share capital. And the Portuguese Cooperative Code forbids the conversion of cooperatives into commercial companies. In conclusion, the Cooperative Code regulates cooperatives with a double concern: preserving the cooperative identity and allowing cooperative entrepreneurship and funding. The last reform of the code, I think, preserve these two objectives: the cooperative identity and allow the modernization of the Portuguese legal regime for cooperatives. And this is my short presentation with my bad English. Sorry for that. Thank you very much.